to improve.
Okay, so let's move on. Most observers agree that Stephen Curry is the finals MVP through two games. Game one, 29-6-9 with five threes. Game two, 33-7-8 with a finals record, nine threes. You see the numbers. He's 31 per, and he was 22.3 per in the three finals from 2015 to 2017. So Andre Iguodala won finals MVP in 2015. Durant last year with over 35 points per game. And is it important for Stephen Curry's legacy to win finals MVP or not?
I don't think it is, but that's because I'm more about the fact that Steph Curry is as enjoyable to watch as any player in the league. The category we didn't have up there is shoulder shimmies. The guy's a joy engine, and their team feeds off of that. So all you have to do is watch the Warriors play, and you understand without any question how important he is to them. I don't think he needs to win MVP for people to know that. What's significant is 40, 50 years from now, when people didn't get to see it and they don't have the emotional vibe that you get from watching Steph play, yeah, it'll be meaningful that he gets an MVP in that situation.
Have you trademarked Joy Engine? Otherwise, Shaq's going to steal it from you. You know that. He'll put it on a T-shirt or
something. I've been using it for a long time, okay. And it's never gone anywhere.
So that's yours.
Feel good. I feel good about it.
I love it. Now, because of LeBron's ridiculous numbers, his name enters the finals MVP conversation, even if his team is on the losing side or down in a series. So, Griff, as LeBron's former boss, and we look at the numbers here, LeBron here in 2018, Jerry West back in 1969, the only player on a losing team to win finals MVP. What do you think about this? Do you think a guy on a losing team could win MVP of the finals or should?
Well, I think in all sports, it's really, really rare. But look at the numbers that we had up there relative to the impact LeBron is having. Obviously, the 51-point outing in game one skews those numbers somewhat. But in Steph Curry's case, he may need to go forward from where he is. He may even need to go and advance himself, have a 40-point night, have that big memorable game, whereas LeBron just really needs to maintain what he's already doing. I think with Iguodala coming back healthy, it may be more difficult for him to do that, but he has absolutely taken advantage of the matchup situation he was in. And again, when you look across all sports, very rare for somebody to dominate in the way LeBron is dominating in the playoffs, leading all of the playoffs in almost every major statistical category. It's not unlike Jean-Sebastien Chaguer in hockey in the NHL when he wins Conn Smythe, right? They lose, but he's so good, you just can't turn away from it.
I love the hockey reference. Mind blowing.